California cops under investigation because they decided to create a bloody takedown because of an ordinance violation. Here it is.
Hey, you don't have to talk to me.
Well, I told you to sit down.
I know.
You know what?
Yes.
Take out your ID, dude.
I know. I have to take it out, but I have to take it out to take the ID out. You know?
Just sit down. Just sit down.
I know, but you have to understand.
Okay.
Hey.
He ends up punching this man. He ends up pushing his head into the concrete. Now remember, this individual was only standing in order to comply. They said, give us your ID. Well, he needed to stand in order to give them his ID, to properly retrieve it from his pocket. He made that clear. Here's what else happened.
Pone tus manos para atrás. ¿Entiendes, sí o no?
Sí, pero no estoy haciendo nada. I'm not doing anything, man.
I told you to sit down, you don't sit down.
Get out of the way.
Stop moving your hand. Leave it on the back.
All skin folk ain't your kin folk, as we say. Let's put up the picture of one officer. Let me go ahead and give you some background to this. It actually happened on the evening of July 27th when a San Rafael officer, Daisy Maza Riegos, confronted the victim, Mateo. Mateo and two other men were drinking beers after work. The area, an industrial section of the Windward Way, is commonly where day laborers come together to socialize. Okay? They don't harm anybody. They actually go there because they don't want to be loud at their apartment complex when they're talking to each other and having a drink after work. Mateo, far left, is a popular county gardener. He explains to the officer that he and his friends come to the area so they don't disturb his neighbors at the apartment complex who may complain of noise. As you saw, is after the initial officer asks for their IDs that things get tense because of this guy, Officer Brandon Nails' attitude. So here's what's happening. One officer says, give me your ID. So he stands up. The other officer says, sit down. And all of a sudden, it becomes about everything but the law here. It becomes about ego. It becomes an issue of status, putting somebody in their place, abusing your authority, everything but the law. It is worth noting, let's put his picture back up. Nail is 6 feet tall, 250 pounds, where Mateo is 5 feet tall and 130 pounds. When the officers lose their temper with Mr. Mateo from his body cam, Officer Nail forces Mateo to the ground over beer bottles, an open container, punches him in the nose, and pushes his face into the rough pavement. You see those pictures? We got the exact screenshot. That's not policy, what that cop is doing. The rest of the footage via transcript shows the varying responses and attitudes the two officers gave over the incident. After the officers loaded Mateo into the patrol car, Officer Maza Riegos in the car door slams, they discussed what happened with paramedics. Unidentified firefighter says, what happened? Was it a fight? The officer says, uncooperative. So we took him down to the ground. Their colleagues, Officer Nail says, his face is blown up. Unidentified cop says, what's that? Officer Nail says, he had a bad day. And their supervisors, unidentified supervisor comes and says, how you doing? Officer Mazariagos got out of hand and then laughs. The unidentified supervisor says, okay, you need anything? The officer says, no, I'm good. Below is what a sergeant says as he walks away from Officer Nail. The sergeant, who's unidentified, says, you're giving me a great experience with use of force, dude. That's what he said. More than 20 minutes after he injured Mateo, Officer Nail walks to the patrol car, snaps a picture, and argues with them. What do you think he's using the picture for? That's his trophy. Snaps a picture. A sergeant already assigned the officers to take evidence, photographs, and Mateo's attorney wonders if this picture was some sort of trophy, as I just explained. Later, Officer Nail wrote in his police report that Mateo, and I quote, reached his right arm around the back of my neck and started to squeeze in an attempt to put me in a headlock, adding, he began to swing his right hand at my head, striking me several times on the left side and back of my head. None of that happened. None of that happened. Not a bit of it. The cop who lied on the police report has now committed a felony offense. Has he been arrested? No. Has he been charged? No. But Officer Nail's report convinced the Marin County District Attorney to file a felony resisting arrest charge against Mr. Mateo and three misdemeanors. The defense attorney explains that the DA filed those charges and set a prelim hearing date without viewing the body cam. Now the charges have been dropped. Let's put up the pictures of the chief. You got Chief David Spiller declined to speak on Officer Nail's record for ABC 7 News. Media officer, Lieutenant Scott Eberly, initially told ABC 7 the officers remained on active duty on Friday. However, also last Friday, he later informed KTVU Fox 2, the two officers were placed on paid leave. The female officer has been an officer for 2 years. Nail has been an officer for 3. All right, so here's the thing. You see, Mateo, the person that you assaulted, he does have a community supporting him. This is part of it. And so we are exposing not only you, but also the ridiculous aspect of this man being charged contrary to the video evidence presented. I'll be damned. Now, hopefully this is a lesson for those who are in law enforcement, but let's be very clear. If it had not been for media getting a hold of this story, if it had not been for the local affiliate of ABC continuing to press the issue, those cops would still be on active duty. Those cops would still be free to harass others in the community. Mr. Mateo never should have experienced this. This is doing a disservice to all cops in this country. You got to get rid of your bad actors among you, because if you do not, the divide between cop and community will grow. All right, Adrienne, thoughts on this?
You know, if that department at all cared about justice, if it cared about its people and its community, it would have already done away with those cops, gone ahead and let them go, because it's clear and evident without question that they were looking to harass someone, that they were willing to lie, to do whatever they could to take advantage of this man, assuming that no one would be able to stand up for him, that he wouldn't have any kind of resources to challenge or push back. They were taking advantage of an individual and violating their civil rights and doing so without batting an eye. This is who they are, and they will continue to do this in the event that they are allowed to continue to be law enforcement officers.
To everyone watching, one of the greatest things you can do for your local community is make sure they have a strong citizens review board with subpoena power to watch over law enforcement activity. All right, we need those more than ever.